gonna do the first coat and then walk away and then come back later and finish it because I want to do it in layers. All right, so I had to, of course, I use all kinds of resin. I used art resin before, so I got art resin. It was very fast delivery to me, fast enough. So anyway, that's why I'm using this one, and I like it. I've always used a couple of different types of resin. I use the stone coat and the epoxy resin store. So those are the main ones I use. Those are very good resin to use. Oh, and Ligari, of course, I use Ligari once or twice again. A very good family stores that could help you when you need help with the resin. So they're always there to help you. Alright, so for this, you don't need a big lump sum of this. Paste. You gotta stir the paste to make sure that it's not sticking to the walls or you're not getting any lumps in it. So I just take like a little bit. See, I drop it in there and close this, put it away. You don't need it anymore. But now, anyway. And I have to stir the resin itself here for about 3 minutes. So I put part A, which is the resin, and I put 8 ounces just to cover the background. And then I put another 8 ounces of the hardener. So it's, you know, A and B, 1-to-1 ratio. Make sure your ratio is completely, you can get these completely right. These containers, I get them at Home Depot. You see, and it says the ounces here. 16 ounces is 1 pint. Resin. So you have to make sure that when you stir it well and scrape off the walls, the bottom. Just keep stirring. Like I said, 3 minutes, and you can even see the bottom. It starts to clear up. To go today with my husband and buy a dress for a wedding I'm gonna go to by the end of this month, the month of June. So gotta go get a dress. I have plenty of dresses. I don't know why my husband's making me buy a new dress, but that's okay. I gotta get Floetrol while I'm out there anyway. I'm out of Floetrol. And that's why my last pour didn't come out as good as it should have. It ran out of Floetrol, got 800. You gotta make sure you have those, you know, extending paint liquids in the paint if you want to do a pour. Just keep stirring. I hope you are all doing fine. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And I have over 1,000 videos there. And don't forget to follow me here on Instagram as well. So usually when I put up videos, I put them up on YouTube and on Instagram. The YouTube is usually a lot longer. So. Wear a mask, but because I'm talking, I'm not wearing a mask. It'll go by fast. Yeah. We got good ventilation down here today. It's very nice and cool. It's not hot at all. Where is my tape measure? So I'm going to put some in the cup.
report first here. Resin. I'll put this tissue here because my gloves have resin. Never. Never double dip on your resin. Just get a new spoon or a new fork and you pick your colors again. Yeah, start the colors all over again. Just a tiny bit. Most of the time I wear the mask. I have a respirator mask. And I usually wear long sleeves so I don't get any resin even on my wrists. Because when it gets on you, it's so itchy. And you don't want that. So when that happens, you gotta wash it off really quickly. So you try not to get it on you at all. You could always wipe these down with a tissue, and tissue full of alcohol, 91%, cleans it very well, and then you could just reuse the knife. All right, so you know that. And this one is ready too. For that guy.
It's usually over $100 for the gallon. For 2 gallons, because you get the hardener and the softener. So it's really not expensive. It's just,
a spreader. I have a spreader somewhere. I don't know where it is. I don't even see it. I don't see it around, so let me just move it around with my hand. Otherwise, it's going to dry up. It's self-leveling, so you don't have to worry about trying to level it out. As long as your table is completely leveled and your canvas is completely leveled, you don't have to worry about it. So, I haven't even done my hair today yet. Just got up and drank some coffee and took a shower. Making sure that it doesn't seep through that tape. So that's why I'm going like that and pushing it real hard to make sure it stays exactly. And you take off your gloves just like we do in the medical field. One inside the other. And that's it. And you toss it. Yep. And then put your bottles away. I put them in a nice warm place and they stay warm. My basement is very warm lately. Summer's coming, so it stays nice and warm. I don't have to warm up and, you know, heat my resin up. So, yeah, as I said, this is a canvas by Aspire. Very good company. They do custom the canvases for you. Your wood boards. And now I'm just going to use it to leave it alone until I come back and do the rest in about an hour or two. This is mostly bursting the bubbles. And you don't want to put it too close because you could burn your resin. Yeah, look at that. I don't see anywhere where it's dripping off more than the other side, so that means my canvas is straight. Hi all, happy Memorial Day. Get out there, take out your barbecue grill and start grilling. Enjoy your day. Love you all.